Hey, what's going on, you guys? My name is Zalu, and welcome back to The Wolf Among Us. Last off, we saw that Faith, is what I'm going to call her, just because the chapter was called Faith, her head was cut off and was placed in front of our apartment where we live, and Snow White and Beauty and the Beast are now involved in this. Which is very strange, but who knows? Let's see, let's continue, because this game is very interesting to me, and the fact that we play as the big bad wolf, and we're trying to kind of like make up for our sins that we did in the past, is very, very intriguing. So, let's continue. Hello.
What, are you blind? What, you don't see there's a line? I've been standing here a half hour already. You get to just walk in? Must be nice being the sheriff. Do whatever the fuck you like. Fucker.
Okay. That was strange.
You were the one bringing this to me, Miss Snow. The one who so simply stumbled upon this catastrophe on our very doorstep. The last thing I need with Mayor Cole away is a hysteria. Do you understand me?
Yes, of course I
do. Don't interrupt me, Miss Snow.
You asked me a question.
Don't change the subject. You are to blame for this unpleasantness, Miss Snow.
I brought you this news as soon as I could.
You are trusted to keep things running smoothly around here. This is a disaster.
It isn't anyone's fault. Instead of trying to assign blame, maybe we should figure out how to catch the fucker who did this.
Right?
Oh, is that how you see things, Sheriff? You are the one charged with protecting the citizens of Fabletown. Your failure to do so cost someone their life and the safety of the entire community.
Tell me,
are there any leads, suspects, anything? Anything at all? Any shred of evidence you two know what the hell you're doing? Because right now, I have half a mind to fire the both of you.
Yeah, her pimp.
Her... was she a...
Yeah. She was worried about a money situation.
Well... this is just wonderful. Not only is a fable,
I chose that just because
it was a fable hooker to boot.
I don't know. Oh, come
we
on
need
now.
To handle on this situation quickly and quietly. The last thing we need is all of Fabletown knowing there's a killer amongst us. Snow.
Yes.
Yes.
Sir?
Call Vivian right this minute and let her know I'm coming in early for my massage.
I will.
Okay.
Where is the bottle of wine you were to purchase? Forget it. Can't do anything right.
Whoa.
Do your job, Sheriff. Or we'll find someone who can.
You know what?
Stop. We'll get on it right away, sir. You would have just pissed him off more.
All right.
Well, that could have gone better. Well... maybe we
new book of fables entry log.
Still think it was better to tell him.
Yeah. Maybe.
Tell him to fuck off.
Crane doesn't like people smoking and never mind.
Crane is an asshole. He got a morning massage.
Who gets a massage this early?
Right?
Crane. It doesn't really matter the time of day.
Who's Crane?
Stress and he's out the door.
Ah, God, Crane sounds so familiar.
Is he gone?
Yes, thankfully.
Is it one of the flying monkeys? It is a flying monkey.
Buffkin!
Hello, Miss Snow.
Drinking? This early?
What? What's up with this? That?
It was by Mr. Ichabod's desk.
Ichabod!
And don't you think it... probably belongs to him?
Maybe.
Ichabod. Hi.
How are you today, Mr. Bigby?
Fine. Not
it
great.
Hasn't been a great morning, Buffkin.
Sorry.
Eh, not your fault. Thanks for asking, though.
Buffkin, get the books.
Which books?
The ones with all the fables.
I'm guessing Buffkin is one of, like, the important flying monkeys of the Wicked Witch of the West.
A few minutes.
Or the... yeah, Wicked Witch. Is it the Wicked Witch of the West?
He knows the ones I'm talking about. there's bound to be information on her here. Somewhere. We'll at least be able to get her real name from the books whenever Beth can find them.
Faith.
In the meantime, is it Faith? Around.
I'm gonna guess Faith.
I really have to get this
mirror on the wall. But
let me know if you need anything.
Who's the prettiest of them all? Oh, is this Aladdin's lamp?
Worth a try.
Yes, that's right.
Magic lamps are pretty much just lamps after the genie's been freed.
Is it though? Like magic lamps? What? How was that ever like a lamp? Let's go towards the mirror. Hello. Hello.
Hey, magic mirror. I got a question.
You know the rule.
Whoa.
I don't have time for this shit.
Your impatience is callow. You're needlessly cruel, but have some respect for our history and rules.
Mirror, mirror. If you're able, tell me all about this fable.
See? Was that so hard?
About 2 seconds away from kicking a hole in you.
There's yeah, no happen.
Need for that. Fine.
Fine.
Of which fable Boop. Do you wish to know?
Woodsman. You don't know her name. Buffkin Snow.
Show me Snow White.
Not much of a request. She's in this very room.
Woodsman.
Show me the woodsman. Where is he?
What you see is complete. The woodsman stumbles down a street.
No shit. Which street?
I'm sorry, Bigby. I can only show you what can be seen.
Okay, so he's drunk. I don't think he has anything to do with it. Buffkin.
Show me Buffkin. Hey, put down the bottle and get to work.
Still looking.
I don't know her name. Not yet, anyway.
Well, until you do, I can't help you.
Damn. Okay.
Nobody right now.
Very well. Please return should you wish to ask about someone else. Or someone new.
Mirror, mirror, on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all?
Well, I'm sure we'll get along. Okay.
That was fantastic. Thank you, Buffkin. Okay. Should I go and read another one of the books? Snow White, Ichabod. Hi. Hello.
Great. What? I can't read any of this shit.
Help. Hello.
Yeah. Thanks.
We look out for each other.
Don't overdo it. Translate.
An exquisite design from the good china of Toad Hall.
Mr. Toad?
He probably wrote this in himself.
Yeah, right. Here we go.
This is the one. Where's this symbol from? Which family or story?
That's an odd one. Family name? Alelairo? I'll go look it up.
Alelairo. That means everything in German.
Donkey skin.
Yes. What does it say?
Donkey skin girl, also known as donkey skin, also known as ass skin, prefers to go by the name Faith. Poetic?
Buffkin, we don't need the commentary.
Yeah, right.
The story of donkey skin. There was once donkey a great skin. King with a beautiful queen. The queen grew ill and had her husband promise to only marry the most beautiful girl in the kingdom. After a long search, it became clear that the only woman in the land that could match her beauty was... his daughter, Faith. She had a magic cloak made from the skin of her father's prized donkey that would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom. Eventually, she married a prince who could see past the magic cloak and knew her true beauty.
Wow.
And they lived happily ever after.
Oh, jeez. Okay.
Should I mark it, Miss Snow?
Yes. Please. And what's her husband's name?
Lawrence. Prince Lawrence.
We got what we came for.
Yeah.
Her name's Faith. She was married to Prince Lawrence. I mean, that's more than
her name was Faith.
Yeah.
Yep.
We should talk to the husband.
You think he did it?
First, I suppose we have to notify him.
No, I don't. But we need to let him know about his wife.
That's sad. What if he's the pimp? Hold on. Let me go back to the mirror.
Mirror, mirror, blah, blah, able, blah, blah, blah about this fable.
Of which fable do you wish to know?
Faith's father, Faith, Prince.
Show me Faith.
Through powerful magic, her whereabouts concealed. Unfortunately for you, these lips are sealed.
Okay.
These lips are sealed. It's not my choice of phrasing, baby. It's simply the way this has to be.
Okay.
Show me Faith's father, the old king.
Okay.
Guess that crosses him off the suspect list.
He definitely had a ring, though.
He's a prince, I think. Show me Prince Lawrence. What's he been doing? Where is this?
Where's what?
Do you know where Prince Lawrence lives?
If he's a prince, probably relocated in the South Bronx. Yellow building, red window shutters.
Red frames.
Yep, that's the one. I can take us there.
Yeah, let's do that, because he has a giant sword. Let's go Faith here one time.
Show me Faith.
Okay, that's, yeah.
Nobody.
Okay, right. Exodine.
Anything we can use?
Yeah. That'll have to do for now.
Come on. We're going over there. Sorry. I have to get that. Hello, Woodland's business office. Yes? He is. Hold on. Bigby. It's for you.
Okay.
Bigby. It's me, Toad. You there?
Sorry about the car.
Yeah, it's fine. Bigby, shit. Listen, right, there's a bloke upstairs going through all the woodsman's things. Get over here, Bigby, before he... Oh, wait, hang on. Boy, shit. Hey!
What was that about?
Hard to say. Something going on over at Toad's place.
What about Faith's husband?
I couldn't really tell. But he could be in trouble.
Oh, God.
Should go there anyway to search her apartment. Toad might have to wait.
Whenever you're ready.
All right, let's do this. This is strange.
Did
Very
Toad say who was there?
Strange.
Was it the woodsman?
I don't know. It's possible. Whoever it was, it didn't seem like Toad was happy to see him.
Well, maybe Prince Lawrence can wait.
Yeah, he didn't see him. He could use some help, too.
Well, where to first?
Oh, shoot.
Bigby, shit. Listen, right? There's a bloke upstairs going through all the woodsman's things.
You think he did it? What's her husband's name?
Lawrence. Prince Lawrence.
Oh, boy. To his apartment or Lawrence... Oh, let's go, Toads.
Toad sounds like he needs help right now.
Yeah.
Check in on Prince Lawrence.
Well, that means Prince Lawrence could be escaping or cleaning up his sword dagger thingy. I don't know, you guys. The frog or the prince? That makes sense. Woodsman's apartment.
And we ended up going out the window, and I landed on Toad's car.
You guys made a real mess.
Yeah. Looks worse in the day.
What's going on? Like, why did it take so long to get here?
Wait here.
Dude, Big Bad Wolf's awesome. He couldn't just escaped.
Shit.
Am I gonna get thrown out a window again? No.
Okay. Sorry.
That's enough, all right? Just shut it.
Wait, whoa, oh God, what's that?
Helen doesn't make this much of a mess.
Okay. I didn't even know that. Okay. Maybe don't kick down the door this time. Maybe just kind of casually open.
Toads, I think.
Be nice in there, okay?
Come on. I'm not that bad of a guy.
Big B and Miss White. Surely you didn't come all this way just for my bother. Sorry, Bigby. It's embarrassing to have to admit, but I thought it was someone else in Woody's place. There wasn't, though. Not when I checked. Nothing but a leaky drain pipe. Imagination must have got the best of me. So, you know, false alarm. Sorry for dragging Miss White into this.
What's going on?
What do you mean? Nothing's going on, Bigby. I don't know what you mean. Truly. False alarm is all. Sorry.
Are you all right?
He's fine, Miss White. Just stung his little toe. Better swimmer than Walker, just like his dad.
Wanna?
So, I guess you'll be taking off now. No need to hang around here anymore. I mean, I'm sorry you came all the way here for nothing. But it was nothing, really.
Someone was here, and something's going on.
Right.
Just so this trip wasn't a complete waste of time, I'm gonna look around a bit before we leave. Okay. The longer you talk, the longer this takes. So just stand over there and shut up.
All right. I just don't want to waste your time, is all. Have a seat. Have a cup of tea. Whatever you like.
Whew. Grown-ups. Am I right? Hey, you know what? Flycatcher said you had a pretty awesome insect collection. I'd really love to see it. Is it in your room?
It has a weevil.
Cool.
Just mind the upholstery while you're looking for nothing.
Yeah, sure thing.
All right, Toad.
How'd this happen?
Fucking hell. Damn thing must have fell off a table.
Uh-huh. Lamp just fell off the table.
Or the boy was faffing about, playing salts and saltfish. Who knows with the lad?
Uh-huh.
Your lock's busted, too. This place is falling apart.
Huh?
The lock. It looks like somebody kicked in the door.
Oh, for Christ's sakes, a fucking lock's been busted for weeks, mate. Right, it's just like everything else in this bloody building.
Likely story.
It's just some wood rot. Not mold or anything.
You bleeding?
Why? Is that...
It's blood. Still fresh.
Oh, well, I cut me hand. Ran around like a tit trying to pick out a wrap. Must have got some on the furnishments.
Sounds painful.
Oi! Don't you go mother-ending now. The wound didn't sit very long, you know. Perks of being a fable, I suppose. And a frog. That more blood?
No, just a clean space in the dust. Did you move something?
Maybe one of Junior's toys or something. I mean, who knows? If you're gonna say something, out with it.
That broken lamp used to be here, right? Just tell me what happened.
Nothing happened, mate. Nothing! And why did the lamp have to be there? Of all the blooming pointless inquiries. It's my own place. Don't you think I'll know what happens in it?
Because the lamp was always over here, Toad. It was over here, and now it's there. The space in the dust is from where you moved.
I did some refiguring. Who fucking cares? Bloody hell, mate. Come on, get off with this. Do a better job dusting, or no?
So what happened?
What happened?
There's fresh blood on the tip. I could smell it from the door.
I was poking the coals and it slipped a bit. Sliced up in my foot like a seashell. Looked like a shit ugly thing. Okay, Sheriff. Now what?
Thought you cut your hand.
You dropped it on your foot? You told me before that you cut your hand.
Yeah, no, I did cut my hand. I cut my hand first, and that made me drop the damn thing on my foot. A ruinous flip of events, really.
Why was it over there?
Oh my God, will you not make a big faff out of this? There's nothing to solve here, Sheriff. I'm telling you everything that happened. Why don't you believe me? I mean... things happen, you know.
This apartment's a goddamn mess, Toad. Looks like after a struggle or a fight. And I don't know why you...
It's crazy.
I know you're lying about something.
But I'm not...
And you're just gonna make it worse for yourself the longer you keep up the act.
I'm not bullshitting you. Honest.
We'll see.
All right, time to open up the window.
What is it now? If it's blood, you know what happened. I...
No, there's marks here on the windowsill. And what's that about?
No real reason. Just last night, when I'd come out, I was in a downright dizzy, mate, as you would be. And I plumb forgot the keys to this place. And I had to climb in through the bloody window.
Really?
Scared Junior off to death. You heard the new Shaken Stevens album yet?
was home. Why didn't he let
Oh, Josh, yeah. You wouldn't need keys. Fuck, fuck, fuck.
To wake him because his daddy didn't remember to check his pockets.
Da-da-da-da-da.
Come on, I'm begging for mercy over here, old boy. I was looking forward to another.
No, I want to go back. I want to go back. Is there a way to go back? There's not.
Just me and me son, and you've taken up enough of a day with all this... They're sniffing around at me private belongings. I'm sorry I called, really I am. But will you please, please just bugger off?
Not yet.
Not yet? No one fought anyone, Bigby. There wasn't any scrap. So when? When are you gonna leave? I mean, I feel like I'm on trial here. In my own bloody home.
When? When you start telling me the truth, Toad?
Well, I've told you the truth, mate. Jesus Christ, what more do you want?
Toad, these stories have made no sense. You didn't cut yourself on the poker. You didn't forget your keys. You want to tell me what's going on?
She doesn't think much of me, I don't think.
Oh, I wouldn't necessarily say that. Progress? Mr. Toad, you're bleeding.
Take off the hat.
It was that butcher, a Tweedle, Dame O'Dea. You gotta strip them down to their johnnies before you can tell which is which. They come bulging in, screaming about something the woodsman had. Or Flotty had, I don't know. He tore up the place, beat me up when I said I didn't have it. I tried to go out the window, but he pulled me back in. It's been a whole morning, I could tell you that.
You know where the Tweedle went?
He mentioned something about Prince Lawrence's. I don't know if he'd already been there.
Was oh, but crap.
I would have told you.
Damn it.
I wanted to, really, I did. But he said if word of this ever got back to him, if he ever thought you knew, or Miss White, he'd come back and kill my boy. I even tried to give the bastard a coat. He wouldn't take it.
Whose coat?
The girl.
Dad borrows things from people who live here. sometimes.
Borrow.
Steal nothing. Turn around here would astonish you, mate. We'll merely repossess what's been left behind.
Well, we'll be taking the coat now. If she has next of kin, family, anyone.
That's all funny. Right.
Flesh and the fur. Fine bit of dress it is. No, I wouldn't wear it out.
Donkey.
Wait.
There's a note. There is a note here.
It's an envelope.
Fucking hell, of course there is. For my luck, it's a map to some bloody doubloons.
It's addressed to Prince Lawrence. Do you want to try and give it to him, or?
Let's open it. Why not? You're the police.
Sorry.
What could she have been sorry for?
I don't
know.
Yeah. Maybe Lawrence does.
Let's go with Lawrence's. It's
quite a surprising day for all of us, hasn't it? I'd see you out, but I'm afraid of dripping any more blood in the place.
It was very nice talking to you, TJ.
Thanks. See ya.
He's so small.
Does it always go that smoothly?
Not often.
So the prince is now?
Lawrence.
Oh, great.
It's our best lead.
Our only lead, really.
When you put it that way.
Right? When you put it that way, I guess so. Alright, guys, I'm going to end this episode here. It is very, very interesting again. I think I went a little bit over my time limit, what I want to do with these playthroughs, but definitely interesting. So Toad was lying to us the whole time until Snow White came out and addressed me like, hey, what's going on? And that's kind of weird. Like, you would think, hey, just tell me. You literally just admitted it to Snow White. Maybe we should have picked Lawrence's first. I'm not 100% sure on it, but I know that in the next one we will see Prince Lawrence. Maybe he'll be gone. Maybe the person will, or Tweedledee and Tweedledum will go to their place instead. Oh, that's not what I wanted. There we go. But let's go look at the Book of Fables. We're going to look at everything. So Faith, Donkey Skin Girl. Faith, otherwise known as Donkey Skin Girl, made through it like an... All right, I mostly just, so this is the Land of Oz. So the monkey was one of the flying monkeys from Wizard of Oz, which is interesting. I like that. 500 or 115 years, awesome. All right, so we will continue this in the next episode, but for now, if you enjoyed this, definitely hit that like button. It lets me know that you guys are enjoying this game and you want to see more of these types of games. I really love these Telltale series games, and I'm so glad that I got to be able to play this. I'm so glad that I kind of saved it for last, because it is very enjoyable and very different from all the other ones. Different in the way of just, this is kind of like a fairy tale land, and that's awesome. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. Alright, well, let me, okay. Oh god, you just cut off my arm. Why are you so strong? You just cut off my, I'm in.